Hello, I am Bishop Earl Boyea of the Diocese of Lansing. During this month of November, we are especially called to pray for the dead. Why would we do this? In fact, praying for the dead is a practice found in the earliest Christian liturgies and encouraged by the early fathers of the Church. Now, obviously, this kind of prayer presumes a belief in a life after death. So please join me for 7 brief reflections on why we Catholics engage in this practice. I ran track when I was in high school, and one of my favorite scripture texts is, "Since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us rid ourselves of every burden and sin that clings to us and persevere in running the race that lies before us." A fourth reason for praying for the dead is that we are all part of the communion of saints, something we profess when we say the Apostles' Creed. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints. It is easy to see that the holy ones in heaven are part of the community of saints. But what about us on earth and those who are in a state of purgation getting ready for heaven? The author of Hebrews goes on to say that we have in this life actually approached the heavenly Jerusalem and the angels and the firstborn in heaven and even Jesus. We here on earth are already linked to the heavenly realm as part of the communion of saints. This union is so clear that St. Paul could say that Jesus is the head of the body, the church. Yet, it is strange to consider ourselves, sinners as we are, as members of this communion. Still, St. Paul calls the Philippians the holy ones in Christ Jesus, and the Romans, to all the beloved of God in Rome, called to be holy. He makes this very clear to the Ephesians. You are no longer strangers and sojourners, but you are fellow citizens with the holy ones and members of the household of God. They, like us, were all sinners. But because of our baptism and our sacramental life, we are already sharing in communion with those in heaven. Why should those in purgatory be any different? Sisters and brothers, we are not in this alone. Our cultural tendency toward extreme individualism leads many of us to forget our calling as the body of Christ, a communion which includes those in heaven who already see the face of God, those of us on earth who are striving to be what we have been called to be, and those in purgatory who are being cleansed for their final entry into heaven.